Welcome to the latest edition of the SWN Podcast. I'm your host, as always, Billy. We're up to episode 195 as I just crawl my way closer and closer to episode 200. Still haven't actually got a guest for that episode yet, so, you know, might still go all go wrong. My guest at this time, though, is he has been on the show under a different name. It was episode 18 way back. It was released October 2020. So just as shows were kind of just getting back to normal, I am joined by Meyhem Brooks. Welcome to the show.
Hello. Hello. So,
great to have you back on, considering that, like I said, when we spoke last, I think you only had a handful of matches and it was pandemic.
I was still a young boy back then.
and you're going by a very, very different name. Still the Grapzilla, but no longer that person. So there may be a bit of a crossover of questions for this kind of like refreshed new episode of the show. So just in case you think I answered that last time, you probably did.
That's fine.
So how you doing?
I'm good, man. I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing all right. Because it was, I mean, to draw back the curtain a little bit here, this episode was supposed to be recorded the week before, but I had to sack off because my wife ended up in hospital. So it was. It was a very weird weekend in general, but we're here, we're recording. I think this is maybe it's just one of those weeks. But here
as
we
long
are.
As, she's all good. Wait, as long as she's all good.
Exactly. She's you may hear screaming later, but it won't be from. I don't think it'll be from her. It'll probably be from my son because his bath time is right about 20 minutes, and the bath's like the other side of this wall. So, just in case. I have set it so it should cancel out any sounds outside of me speaking, but just in case you hear screaming, it's fine. It's controlled. We know what's happening.
Everyone's good.
Exactly. If I run away, it might be a bit different. So glad to have you back on, because like I said, the last time we spoke, it was pandemic, so nothing was happening. I think, nothing, because your re-debut in Target was August the year after, in 2021, so it was...
Well, that didn't even happen because I got cancelled again.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, one didn't even happen again, so yeah, didn't get that one. But hopefully, I managed to show up at that place again. Well, not again, but show up there and put my mark down. You know what I mean?
Absolutely. So yeah. So during that time, it was you were a different name, different person, and then you've reinvented yourself. I got yourself into incredible shape just because you didn't have much else to do, really. It was work out or get fat, and I chose the latter, but you chose to get fit instead.
I just lifted heavy things and put them back down in that pandemic.
I lifted sweet things and didn't move. But eventually you did get back into action. Note I've got here is December 2021. That was WTL, of course. I don't know if you had a couple matches beforehand, but this is the
no,
one
I think that was. I think that was the first one back after it, yeah.
What?
Didn't go to plan.
I know, yeah, what a chaotic show to come back to then, because, I think that was one of those days where just nothing went right for W3L, and it was very... So you must have been up here, though, so it wouldn't have been that much of an issue for you getting over to the show.
No, it was fine for me. I was on the good end. It was just everyone else that was a bit stressed out and all that stuff, you know?
And everyone's like, they've had to, I think, was it their lockup, their compound was locked and they couldn't get into it, so they had to borrow a ring from another promotion. And then they were like an hour and a half late from opening, and then you would have just rocked up and went, how's it going, guys? Let's go do the wrestling.
I was just there, but eventually everyone showed up, stressed, sweating, all that stuff. I was just chilled out. I was like, oh, we need to get going. I'm ready, let's get sorted, you know, but it got going, show went well, it was all good.
Yeah, the weird thing about it, like, right, so this show, this is the first, I think it would be the first time I've, no, I saw you do the Christmas Battle Royal, I think you did the last time, did the Elgin, but this is the first time I've seen Meyhem Brooks wrestling, and it was just weird, because it was like, I don't know if you had a plan or thought of planning this at all, but yeah, they called your name and then you didn't come out, and then you kind of got thrown out through a door because they didn't have the staging set up.
I was in a different room. I didn't hear them shout my name. All of a sudden, like, get in there, chuck me in. They caught me off. That's why I lost. They caught me off guard. I didn't have time to prepare myself. That's what it was.
You did seem shaken. You did seem a bit off your game because it was just especially with an opponent like Mackie as well. So it was just a very interesting night. I wrote about it. I won't go into the whole ins and outs of it, but it was nice to actually just get back into doing wrestling with someone in a ring and just
it felt good. I missed it. I definitely missed it.
Did you? Was there anything that you thought a bit rusty on? Was when you made that first land to the mat? Where you're like, oh, I don't.
All of it. All of it was rusty on all of it. But that no, the first bump after that pandemic, like after that COVID, actually, the wind out me a little bit.
It's just crazy to think what it's been. I think as of this week, it's been 3 years since it was 3 years since I was sent home and working from this house forever. It's just crazy to think that how far we've come, as especially when it comes to entertainment. When I've seen these shows with massive crowds again, you're thinking, Jesus, 2 years ago, it was everyone
what had is to wear COVID?
Masks. Exactly. So from that point onwards, of course, WPL came back. Elgin, that seemed to be like there's a bit of a gap in between there before you end up at Respect again. Was it just a case of was it an injury? Was it just a case of just circumstance?
Not injury nothing, just sort of finding my feet again, you know what I mean? Reinventing myself. It was like starting from scratch again more than anything.
Yeah, trying to lay your brand out again because, of course, you were
pretty much
your real name, so you needed to kind of build up the Meyhem Brooks brand to get back out.
I think it's went well so far, though. I think I'm doing well for myself.
Absolutely. I mean, seeing that, like, there's quite a lot of buzz about yourself as well from likes of Pro 2. Speaking of which, they sent me a bunch of questions. I've just remembered as I've mentioned them. It's certainly. I mean, there's still gifts going about of you knocking the brains out of you, you know, Raw as well. So there's always good stuff you get to see on social media when it comes to that. So as far as getting back on your feet then. So of course, rebranding as Meyhem Brooks. I think you spoke on the Northeast Corner podcast about how that kind of came about.
Yeah.
But for those unaware, why Meyhem Brooks?
Well, it was more starting off. I wanted to. The name was the first one we needed to change. And Meyhem is. Well, Meyhem Lorenz, my favorite rapper. So I was like, I love the name Meyhem. I need to use that. But the last name was the hardest one, trying to find that sort of add on to there. And I was. I can't remember if it was on the phone, the Daz block, or a text. I can't remember what it was. And he was somewhere, and he said, I went past this pub. I think it was called, I don't know what the first name was, something and Brooks. He was like, just call yourself Meyhem Brooks. That's a good one. I was like, Meyhem Brooks, that's all right, that is. So just went with that. Not giving Daz any credit, because Meyhem was my idea. He was in the right time and place to give me that. But
I could have all went wrong. Mayhem Weatherspoons.
Exactly.
Mayhem Muckle.
Mayhem Muckle. Mayhem Weatherspoons. Mayhem Granary. It could have been anything, couldn't it? Mayhem Foggies. Imagine that.
Oh, I was going to say Mayhem Mayhem Badenix doesn't actually sound that bad.
Might have to use that in another one, in another lifetime. But Meyhem Brooks right now, I'm liking it. It goes with my attitude. Nasty, aggressive. You know what I mean? Just, it sounds right.
So how are you still kind of just trying to keep yourself in that time where you're rebranding? Were you just watching some promos? Were you watching more wrestling? Just what was your kind of wrestling lifestyle during that time?
Through the rebrand, it was more when you see me wrestle before I did reinvented myself. I don't know how to explain it. I wasn't fighting the way I know how to fight. Like, I've got my background, very good grappler, all that sort of thing. I wasn't using what I know, and I thought it's time that, like, added my style to the wrestling game. And I just started adding my attitude, my nastiness, my aggressiveness, all that sort of thing. And since then, it's worked for me better. I've felt better doing it this way. I just feel good right now with all this, you know what I mean?
It's more natural. You feel like
I'm comfier. I'm a lot more comfortable now.
I don't know if it would have been a reason for why, but of course, we all know what happened during lockdown and what have you. Of course, you had to find a new place to train and and what have you. So we're in case of kind of shaking off what you'd learned as a, I don't know how it would have been you trained at the previous place, but like as a sports entertainer, you're trying to shake that off because you want to be a pro wrestler kind of thing. You want to kind of implement your own wrestling ability.
Exactly. It is that, yeah. Just wanted to implement my own style into the game. Like, I feel like when I get in the ring with someone, they, as soon as I feel that first like grab, or as soon as I get hold of someone, I'm like, oh, like, not used to it, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. I mean, I saw the difference between, so that match in December 2021, I don't know if you read what I wrote about it, but I wasn't a fan of it, to be honest. I think it was just more the chaos of the whole evening as well. Didn't help. But when I saw you again in July, I don't know who that was, because it wasn't the guy I saw in December. Because you had this incredible back, you had a great match with the Tormentor, which is difficult as it is. But to see you come out as, especially, of course, to find your feet again, you came out in December, you weren't looking for any fan validation, you weren't looking for...
No.
But when you came out for, was it Summer Spectacular it was called? At the Town Hall? That you just embraced everyone, and it seemed everyone was just there to see Meyhem Brooks batter. So was that another important thing for you, just to kind of feel comfortable, feel natural, and
get comfortable? And I don't think the nerves in December helped either, because off for so long, this was it, like basically like a new debut, basically like starting again, going out there with who I am now. Just had to shake off all the nerves, all that stuff, the ring rusting up December 1. What happened, happened, went how it went. July, more experienced. Did it, you know what I mean? Got the Meyhem Brooks sort of style under my belt, and then was ready to show it off and perform to the hometown as well.
Absolutely. I mean, the Town Hall is a really great venue. I don't know if it's just,
great,
if it's expensive to run or anything like that, but they really padded it out. They did had the lights, and it just looked really cool. And no pressure at all, but you had Doug Williams there as well.
Exactly, yeah. So when you know he's there, you got to be on your best perform as well, because you want everyone to see how good you are when you're out there, don't you?
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, that show itself, I mean, if everyone's got W3L Network, go back and watch it, because it was a really great show in general. Of course,
I enjoyed that a lot, I did, yeah.
Yeah, you were against the Tormentor, of course, but like I say, he's a bit of a difficult customer, and you put on a really good showing with him, and of course main event
I fucked him up
pretty much. I mean, you did do it as quick as Nathan Reynolds did back in the December, where you just like speared him and that was it, but you know, you needed to get some practice in and torturing people, and the Tormentor was there for
I had to give Elgin a show, and there was a lot, I knew a lot of people in that crowd, so I wanted to make sure their money was worth it seeing me out there.
And of course, Pro 2 being in our place, so you've now debuted and you've, well, at least competed for championship gold as well. So was it like trying to, Pro 2's kind of got a good mix of people that are on the show that you would have come across through training, through pre-pandemic as well. So what was it like debuting in Pro 2?
That was enjoyable as well. My debut was on the over 18 show. Another, their summer show as well. I think I've got a thing for summer shows. That was the Venue 38, I think it was called. That debut there, that was a good one as well. Different sort of crowd for me as well, you know. Adult show, so that was, I really enjoyed that. I think I felt more comfortable doing that show than I did wrestling front of kids.
But yeah, it's a different beast. I mean, I haven't seen that many over, I don't think I've actually been to an over 18 show, because I like the kiddie element of wrestling. I like the big character sports entertainment. Because I think that was a show where it had Iceman and his son Jack just bleed and bat at each other, which is not something you see in a lot of wrestling shows, especially up here.
That was my first one I've seen in live as well.
Oh, I bet that was, yeah. Is that one of those moments where you see that happen? You're just like, oh, I don't know how much of it is kind of how much. Afterwards, it's going to be like, all right, we have to get this guy to a hospital straight away, or is this going to be quite patched up? Is this right?
The whole time I was thinking, bro, I would not hit my dad like that. I would not do that.
I never see the future. Meyhem Brooks Jr. And then that's it. 20 years' time. Light tubes and glass. I don't know what else was there.
glass, forks, everything.
Oh no, it's not my kind of wrestling, but you know, for each to their own. I know people like, I mean as a UFC fan yourself, MMA fan, you're used to a little bit of blood at the very least, so it's something that
I'm
you're
like
kind
that
of
meme, the guy that's got just bleed on his chest. I'm that guy.
Oh no, it's just, yeah, give me a OA Scotland versus England, yay boo. I'm all over that. That'll do me. But yeah, we do have some questions from Logan Storm from Pro 2 Wrestling. So some of them I think will impact if you're booked again for them if you answer the first one wrong. Which is, do you like working Pro 2?
Of course I do.
So at the moment, of course, you had the match with Krieger as well, big lad. I saw the gifs, I saw the videos of you just throwing him, which is impressive in itself. And then you had the triple threat as well with Frank Cross and Stone Malone, and then of course another match with Frank Cross as well. So and Lucha DS. Yeah. So you've a fair variety of opponents at Pro 2 already. So is that something that you quite enjoy, just having lots of different styles of matches?
Everybody's different so far. I've wrestled, yeah, everyone's different, so it's testing my skills and just, I don't know, it's just a good vibe wrestling in that ring as well with all them sort of guys, you know what I mean?
I've heard the Bounce Station shows as well, they're good laugh,
cause yeah, well that was the last one I just done against Lucha, and that was a good venue. That was,
you know, I like the sound. I like seeing the setup as well, because it's like you're in the corner a bit, but then there's all these trampolines everywhere. It's like, right, there must be a point where you're just going, right, if I can get him, Lucha, actually, no, Lucha's probably a bad example for this, but if you get just closer to the trampolines, just get to the trampolines, or you told explicitly beforehand, don't do that, don't go near the trampolines.
I wasn't told personally, but I had a feeling. I'm not going to lie, though, when I was fighting Lucha, there was a punch received. If I had a pound coin in my pocket, I would have pressed and rammed his head through there, breaking the record.
So there are questions we've got from Logan. We've got, what are your hopes in Pro 2?
Be a champion.
Well, that leads on to...
Always top goals, question. Isn't it?
Absolutely. And the last question he's asked, of course, is what titles are you eyeing up? So we've got they name them too many things. I'm trying to remember what they're called. So we've got the Interpromotional Championship.
Got the Jokers.
The Jokers.
Well, the Wise will see it, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Jokers Division, sorry.
I've kind of half given up putting them on when I'm doing the results, going, I don't know, is the YSO serious, is the Joker's division, I don't know, either or. And then you've got the Ayrshire, believe, heavyweight championship, which tag team titles as well. So is it just any and all, or any in particular?
All the belts.
All right, okay.
Give me that interpromotional, so I can walk around everywhere with that on my shoulder.
Fair enough. Would you be a guy that would be the kind of guy who'd be walking up Elgin High Street next to the Dandelion with the Scottish Interpromotional Championship over your shoulder?
I'd be wearing that in Joe's and everything. Be cracking open bottles of beers and all sorts of that thing.
So it'd be the most expensive thing in Joe's. If you're wearing that. Oh,
more
man.
Expensive than carpets and dance floor. Everything is sticky.
See, I think we mentioned it in last time we spoke, way back in 2020, but I'm fairly certain their theme nights, their foam nights, was just to clean the place.
Definitely.
Because I've been there, when was last? I was there for my stag do, because I don't like going out, so we just went for a curry and went to Joe's, was the last place open. Oh, it's a horrible place.
I don't remember the last time I've been there, to be honest.
Oh, it's just... It's something. Something.
It was good to get. It was good for your first night out. Then after that, you're like, right, I need to move on from here.
I know it literally is the place where you're in. Like, this is great chat for anyone who's not from Elgin. But so yeah, it's like one of those things where you're in granary. It's like we're in the granary, and you just go, right, oh, I'm still fancying drinks. Oh, what's open? Oh, Joe's is open. Oh, Joe's, right. Nobody's from Joe's going to be watching this, I guess. But they started charging.
Dicey's all the way. That's the one.
Dicey's, that's where you go. Karaoke night. You feel a little bit dirty being in there. It's a bit scummy, but the measures are done by eye, and that's the most important thing when you're looking for a it's just, well, they just go, aye, that'll do. It's like, yes, please. £1.20 mixer. Yes.
Yeah, give it to me.
God, I haven't been dicey. I've actually been outside this house in years, to be honest. Outside of going to the wrestling, that's about it.
Like, I saw you a couple of days ago walking the dog on my way to work. Saw you when I went past in my van. So that's how light that is.
Okay, I'll rephrase that. I haven't been anywhere exciting for a few years. I've went to the field across the road with the dog. That's about it at the moment. Did you too? I feel like
that's
I've
what
been.
I saw you.
That's fair. That must be it. So yeah, that was
no,
the
I
question.
did it too because I wasn't driving. I was a
Right, okay. Yeah, that's dangerous. You don't want to do that if you're day driving. Just slam your hand over and get it to it. Right, so we'll get to we're back at W3L because of course last time I saw you was Elgin again. Of course, it's the only place I see you. It was December 2nd, so about a year after your return to wrestling. And it was, oh man, what a night. It was Bishop Mill Hall.
Oh,
you were against
loud, wasn't it?
Yeah, you were against Craig Stevens. It was for the breakout championship. Yeah, no, Wrestle Showdown Championship, wasn't it?
Yeah, no. You were right. First, I'm sorry. It was for the breakout.
It was breakout. And yeah, this was a loud night. So it was back at the Bishop Mill Hall. They had all the bells and whistles. They had the lights. They had the entrance. It looked like a proper show. Like I said last time, it was
that was good.
Big crowd for it as well, and. You had, I'm guessing most of it was your mates in the back rows anyway, who were just going ballistic the whole night because they were loud. They were getting involved as well.
They set the tone. I'll give them that.
Oh yeah, I mean, especially when they were trying. When I can't remember who it was. I think it was Iron Drew was taken. I can't remember who it was. Hugo Harris. That was it. Was taking him to ringside, and your mates were just jumping over to try and get a wee dig in as well. The kids were giving him a wee slap on the chest, and I was seeing grown adults come in just for a wee dig, just going, "Aye, go on in. I'll give him a batter as well." But this is a great match because I've got, of course, your profile picture, your background picture on Twitter is one I took myself.
Yeah, that was a good shot. You done me justice there, mate.
But yeah, how was it going into that match then? So, you know, big crowd, all pretty much there, most of them to see you at the very least. Championship match against Craig Stevens. Just thoughts going in, thoughts coming out, thoughts during.
The normal nerves before I go out there. Then when my name got announced, I heard the noise and it sort of, as soon as I heard the cheers from like people I know, it just flushed out all their nerves and just pumped me. I was ready to get in there. Got in there, did my thing. But he done me a little bit dirty and got away with it, didn't he?
He did, and people were not happy. I think
no,
I think if it was I think if it was a licensed bar, absolutely. I think if it was a licensed bar at the Bishop Mill Hall, I think that would have been a riot, to be honest.
That would have been madness if there was a licensed bar there.
Absolutely, yeah, because like I can't do it justice. I don't think I did any videos during the shows either because they'd have their lighting that kind of dimmed that every time I put my camera up, the flash automatically went on when I was videoing. And I was like, oh no, this is very awkward, especially if they're recording it for Wrestling Showdown. Because I did that at the town hall. I thought I'll get a couple of videos for road trip episodes. As soon as I put my camera on, massive light, and I saw some staff just look over. I was like, oh no, pictures it is. I'm not getting thrown out of this, but for taking video. But yeah, so yeah. Did your mates see afterwards and message you afterwards? Just either calling Craig Stevens all the names under the sun or just what was it?
We had a party after that and we got mad drunk. We went out and got pretty lit after that one.
Would have been better with a belt though, eh?
Yeah, well, that's what I'm saying. Next time he's in Elgin, we got to run that back and I'm going to be snatching that belt off his hands.
Honestly, I was on the edge of my seats because I thought it was going to happen. I was sitting there just
bro,
like,
"I had him, I had him."
It was just, oh man, I was biting in. You know me, I've watched wrestling for long enough that I could be jaded if I wanted to be, but no, I was there biting for every bit, and I was like, oh my god, had to get the aerial shot because I thought that's not going to happen often. Go get a picture of this.
No, you don't see me jumping very often.
but it was just, yeah, it was fantastic, and just to think that. Like I said, in that journey, as someone who saw those three matches, the Elgin matches back to back to back, just to see you become more confident and more natural as yourself. I mean, I don't know, outside of Elgin, outside of Murray, that you're a bit more aggressive, a bit more of a bad bastard about it. But especially in Elgin, you'd really properly just felt like a natural good guy because everyone wants to see the local lad do good.
That's it, yeah. We don't get enough wrestling here. So when we do, I want to show everyone we can't, like, I think I'm the only guy from here that does it, aren't I? I'm pretty certain I am.
Definitely, I think, yeah.
From this town anyway.
I think there's a couple boys from, I know Connor Malloy, we grew up in Forest and what have you, but yeah, definitely Elgin anyway. You're the only that I know of anyway.
So when wrestling comes here, this is my favorite place to wrestle. I'm not even going to lie about it. I love wrestling at home. Just hits different for me.
So especially if you're like, so you've grown up here, that you've seen shows at the town hall or you've seen shows in places and now you're actually being, I mean, I've already mentioned the town hall, but it's wooden. It's just a really nice, cool venue.
That's it. Elgin Town Hall deserves more wrestling shows, without a doubt.
I absolutely agree. And that's not just because it's literally like 5 minutes away from it. And
it's not. It's a good venue. You get always a good crowd. Everyone enjoys it here.
Absolutely. I don't know why. I mean, thankfully, W3L kind of recognized that. It's still two shows. Still not enough for me. But still, it's two shows.
They got a show every weekend, haven't they?
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. They could expand. You could do Murray. You could just
exactly.
That's it. We're setting up Murray Wrestling. That's what we're doing.
Exactly. Let's do Elgin. Let's do Forest. Let's do Keith. Throw Falkenbuzz and Lumberiding now. Go for it.
Rothis, I've always wanted to run a show in Rothis because that's where I grew
do
up.
Do it! Even chuck Burghead in there as well.
God, there's enough scraps in Burghead to. We don't need to set up a wrestling show. We just have to get there at Clavey time. I'm sure there'll be plenty. plenty fighting there. I've now just spun off into thinking, right, who am I booking for this show? Anyway, right, okay. Who's nearby?
Me. Me.
Of course. Hometown hero. Main event. That's the first thing that's happening. Once I get the belt made and everything. back to the questions. We'll get back into them because we've got loads on Twitter, got a few on Instagram as well. So nice load of questions. So we've got Stone Malone, of course, who we mentioned, who had that match at Pro 2 for the Interpromotional Championship. I think he was the champion at the time. I think, wasn't it Frank Frost?
He was, yeah, but
it's just asked when we scrapping then.
Whenever he wants to get his arse kicked and get slapped up, ASAP.
I mean,
Frank took it away from us. Me and him 1-on-1, smack each other up the wood.
I mean, of course, Source Wrestling Champion. I don't know if you've got a match. I mean, I think you do because actually Pro Wrestling have got a question about it. But I'm assuming you're eyeing up that Battle Royal on May 5th for Rugby Mania to go and face Stone Malone for the Source Wrestling Championship.
I'd like to face up against Stone Malone, but I think I've got a little opponent who's waiting for me, Robbie Cardwell. I don't know if it's been announced yet. Oh, whoops! But
that'll be fun because he's a big high flying guy against someone who, of course, will be looking to ground him and twist him and break
that's
him.
It. He's going to try and keep it aerial. I'm just going to keep him on the ground. I'm the ground shark. That mat is my ocean. And I'm like, as soon as I get you on the ground, you ain't getting up.
Love that. Ground shark. That's T-shirt. That's your T-shirt.
I said, Grapzilla, eyes you.
We've got Atrip Wrestling, of course, asking, you got a message to whoever your opponent is on May 5th. So now we know it's Robbie Cardwell. So, I mean, I'll take the heat on this one wanky I sounded there. I'll take the heat on this one if Attitude Pro Wrestling are like, no. I'm sure it'll be announced before this comes out on April 7th. Be fine. So yeah, any last word? Any more words for Robbie Cardwell before you go and slap him?
He just better be ready. That's all it is. Like I said, it's different as soon as I get hold of you. I ain't worried one bit about that man. I'm confident in myself. Fair he's enough. Great, he's good, he's good, he's good, but he ain't good enough to beat me.
Have you been studying some aerial? I mean, of course, Bobby Cardwell's got a couple matches on WWE Network. I actually don't know if they're still on WWE Network. That's
I've actually known Robbie for quite a good time. I've known him for a long time, actually. No beef or nothing. It's just straight down to business, isn't it?
Fair. Yeah, absolutely. It's a winner's purse at the end of the day.
Exactly. He's just a road bump in the way to glory.
Yeah, and of course, don't know if actually pro wrestling have got titles on the way. I'm assuming that maybe in the pipeline. So, of course, wins equals titles.
Wins equals belts, and Mayhem looks good with a golden strap around him.
We've got Judas Gray. God, he's just why this question keeps coming back every time that we do this. Judas Gray asking DMG question mark.
What does that
mean? Oh,
I don't know what it means.
Anyone who listens to this podcast knows I've had to explain this every time, and I feel like I'm now just Judas Gray's like disciple of advertising his DMG. So
is this like one of his little golfy things that he likes?
Right, when I explain it, there's one day I'm going to do this, and it's going to be so awkward. DMG stands for Dead Mum Gang.
Dead Mountain Gang, do you say?
Dead Mum Gang.
Oh. No. I'm not part of that, thankfully for me.
There's going to be a day I'm going to do this, and the person I'm speaking to's mum's going to be dead. And it's going to be the worst thing to ever. It'll be great for everyone else watching it. It'll be the worst moment in my life.
Not for you. It'll be rough for you, mate.
That'll be when the episode ends. I'll be like, oh, Dead Mum Gang. Oh, my mum died last week. Oh, cancel. Cancel. We're out. We're gone. And you also put Wanna Run It Again, Pussio.
Run it again. Ugh. Me and him banged it up in training one day, and I mean, it was a little bit competitive, but still throwing him about like a wet Rocky, innit?
I haven't seen Judas Gray actually. Like, right? I've seen bits and pieces. I haven't actually seen him have a full match yet. He seems a bit of an odd cat. Is it a bit of a style you have to adjust to, or are you just more a case of just grabbing a body part and then control it?
Yeah. You just got to let him get a flip in there, then grab him once he's done that little flip.
They also asked, we actually asked a legit cool question, which I'm interested in. You put follow up, what is one move you think should be put in the bin?
Oh. What was the Xbox move called again? Bronco Buster, was that what it was? Where he jumps on the ropes and just... Was that what it was, Xbox? Was that what it was called?
Yeah, well, he was sitting in the corner and he would run up and rub
bin
his crotch
that,
in your face.
Bin that.
Nah,
yeah,
nah.
Bin that.
Yeah, father, the Bronco Buster. No, that's nay.
I don't want none of that in my face.
So I'm assuming a lot of crotch base, so you wouldn't want a Shattered Dreams either. That might be quite low on the list of what.
Yeah, I don't want it. No, none of that. Stay away from that area, please.
So, unfortunately...
Give Craig some notice on that. Kicking me in my nuts on that night as well.
Oh, and it's a big night. I assume that he put some extra spice on that kick.
Oh, that was a sore one.
We end up back there again, but so it would have been one of those moments where it was first half main event as well, mm-hmm. in that match. So you were tasked with staying out as well after getting your plums kicked, and you were doing the Polaroids and all that kind of stuff. How weird was it that you were in, like I said, you're in Bishop Mill, Elgin, being the big superhero to all these kids coming in, getting the photo, getting the Polaroids? Was it just, did it feel right? Or was it still a bit mind-blowing?
No, it felt right. It felt like I'm the hometown hero. I felt like a hero on that night. Funny thing is, though, like when I'm getting photos with kids, I'm like, I know your dad. Oh, I know your dad as well.
I mean, it works the other way. If you come out during the show and you decide that you're not wanting the fan support that night, you can literally just go, I could beat up your dad. I know your dad. I could beat him.
Exactly. Probably have beaten half of them up already.
So we've got loads of questions. We've got a couple of questions on Instagram, so I'm just going to drag them up because I'm old. So I have to kind of look at it like I'm an old man. We've got Tom Humphreys, of course, a.k.a. I've just dead-named him. Tom Atlas. Here he's put that shoot hit toss with Uno Raw. I think we spoke about this already.
That shoot hip toss with Uno Raw.
I think we spoke about this already. I think it was you. I think it was when you and the the big strong man, had like a thing in training, and he hip tossed you, and he wouldn't shut up about it.
Big strong man. Oh, big strong man. He hit me with a mad hip toss. But everyone's like, oh, you got hip tossed by a big strong man. Big strong man is a judo brown belt. Did nobody know that? He is legit.
I think I remember when we spoke about it last time. You were, I think it took you off guard, but you like was one of those you wouldn't let it happen again kind of thing. Have you?
No.
Nah, grappled again with big
that's
strong
one
man?
I'll adapt to. I'll adapt to that.
Fair.
But it's one of those things as well. Judo, jiu-jitsu, just another little thing in the rivalry between me and him.
So, but there's a big strong showdown in the future where you've already formulated a counter for it.
Oh, I hope so, because I need to knock him on his ass.
And of course, we've got Rob Stowe as well. Just put, what scares you the most?
What scares me the most? Probably my hairline.
Yeah, Pro 2 did not do you justice for that particular picture that I used for your original thumbnail for this chat. See, I didn't think it was that bad, but look at my hairline. I think anyone who has hair in general is better than me at that point.
Once I've got my name out there a bit more and decided to take a bit of time off, I am straight to Turkey for that transplant, man. I'm going for that.
Would you like to? I mean, the mullet seems to be in at the moment. Would you just be wanting to go full on for it, or just enough mullet. Just to cover the hairline?
Just enough. So even this bit out, I'm not taking the hat off because I've already said it scares me. But just get it nice and flat, skin fade it, keep it nice and short, and that's me happy.
Oh man, like I say, I cannot join this conversation. I mean, you can see the ridge where my hairline should be, and it is just not there anymore. I mean, I did cut my hair today, but even then it all grows out, but this bit is blonde, so blonde, and this bit comes out brunette like a horseshoe.
The beard's really dark as well.
I know that. Well, this is the color of the hair that comes out at the side, but this bit just comes in full blonde, so it's just, if it grows out, it just looks, you know what, my son's got more hair on top of my head on his head at the moment than I do. It's just ridiculous. It's just, he looks bald because it's so fair and blonde, so it's just pretty weird. But anyway, yeah, don't need to speak about hair any more than we have to. So when we're speaking about, well, I listened to your chat on Northeast Corner, of course. I went onto their show recently as well, and it was a good laugh. They were at the WTL show also in support.
Yeah, they were there as well. Yeah.
What's it like getting onto other podcasts? I know you did Jason Hyde, who's no longer Jason Hyde. So is that again more part of your rebranding? Was trying to get your voice out a bit more and
that's it. Yeah, no, I've never really been one for obviously speaking too much. So just that's another thing: getting on podcasts, getting to show people what I'm when I'm not in that ring. Obviously, when I'm in the ring, I'm nasty, aggressive, all that. But it's just business in there. So I'm a nice guy.
That's
I think
it.
So anyway. But no, I enjoy it. I like your podcast.
That's it. I mean, of course, when we did it, was episode 18. Was it? So it's been way back then now. It was one of the first few podcasts. I didn't do a lot of research because I've learned now I need to do research. Of course, if you're this is one of your first podcasts, I think it's one of the shortest ones we've done, is like 30 minutes, because I think I didn't have the questions, and then you, of course, were trepidatious about podcasting. So both of us were kind of like working out together, trying to figure out
how this works.
And now here we are, about 40 minutes in, and we've already talked about you going to Turkey to get a hair transplant. You know, that's just that's just how things work. Also,
you have to get me back on. Once I get that done, I'll be back on here with no hat. Oh, look at this.
Just got a wee headband on just to keep it all up, just keep it out your face. And
I'm gonna be a different man. I don't know, just Meyhem, Good Line, Brooks, that sort of thing. Oh.
Mayhem flowing locks, Brooks. Oh. Flowing locks. There we go. Submissions. you got it.
Oh, bro. See, you're doing the Dallas Black treatment. You're gonna be taking the credit now.
Oh, I'm telling you, there's wrestlers out there that have to thank. They've never given me credit. I mean, I'm not saying that nobody called Anastasia the beauty for the borders until I did. but I did. And then she took it. She picked it up. Didn't get any credit for it. Shocking. But no, any wrestler wants some ideas, I'll give you some. They'll be like...
Straight to you.
Exactly. Like 1 in 5 will be good. You know? Just, but that one will be the best thing ever. So nowadays, we're back. Of course, wrestling's back and flowing. You've got some matches coming up. Of course, you've got that match at Attitude. No doubt you'll probably have a match at Pro 2 when they do their...
Yeah, I've stuff. also got Peterhead.
Of course, Peterhead. Mm-hmm. Again, a fairly short journey in comparison to...
Yeah, for once.
So Peterhead, who have you got again?
I've got The Wanderer and I've got Lee McRae.
Oh, of course. Okay, so Wanderer, of course, we were due to speak to him. I was due to speak to him a couple of days, actually, so I'll get his thoughts on your match as well. But Lee McRae...
Well, you can tell him from me that he's a bitch.
that'll be my opening line. Like, how you doing? Meyhem Brooks says you're a bitch. Thoughts. But Lee McRae, I don't know this name. So I'm assuming he's coming out of Community Pro Wrestling's school or Iron Girders or something. Do you know much about Lee McRae?
I more know him of him outside of wrestling. He's another MMA background guy. So,
all right, okay.
That's how I know of him.
Oh, I feel bad for the Wanderer. Suddenly,
I mean, I might have to focus on me because I've got to prove I'm the real deal, not him.
Is there anyone up here like in MMA? Because I know there's a few. Aiden Stevens.
We've got a cool SBG gym up here, haven't we? We've got Doug Nevins, the freestyle wrestler. We've got Kevin Markaloon, jiu-jitsu. Martin Donaldson, jiu-jitsu. Aiden, like you said. That I can't remember his last name. That young Ethan guy, the K1 kickboxers. A lot of talent in MMA. Not enough talent in pro wrestling.
Is there any guys that you've been trying to... Not, like, can you split their time? You know, MMA is fine and all, but, you know.
Well, that's where I started off at SBG Murray. That's my background. I know all them guys.
I do know
Aiden Stevens is a massive wrestling fan and wants to get involved in it. But obviously, he's chasing that Cage Warriors goal just now.
So you think that might be once he completes that, hits the mountain in MMA, he could be a guy that might try and transfer over.
Mm-hmm. I've seen him do a few things. He's got talent. He's done a little bit of training up in Aberdeen as well, Wrestle Zone. He could make it. He could do well in this. So it'd be fun to mix it up and that. Mix it up with the gloves on, so mix it up in the ring as well.
Yeah, so does that be, is there anyone else? I mean, you mentioned those names, but is there anyone out of those that you think they could probably do well? They could embrace
Doug Nevins as well. He's a tough grappler like myself. I'd like a lot of boys really, yeah. Doug Nevins would be a good one as well.
So I mean, if you don't get the ring with them, that'd be quite an imposing stable as well of wrestlers up in the Northeast, just going in, stretching folk. And
imagine us, if me, Aiden Stevens, and Doug Nevins, if they ever came to this world, we would be trouble for everybody.
Because you don't get, there's not a lot of that in Scotland at the moment as well. When it comes to that, I mean, we've got, of course, down in ICW recently, we had of course Chris Bungard and Paul Craig, here. So that's kind of it when it comes to, I don't want to say legit sarcastically, but like legit wrestlers, like the guys that are doing MMA and doing like actual contact. Mm-hmm. Does sound right.
It's all legit. Just different rule sets, different styles, different styles clashes, you know, that sort of thing. It's all legit.
I think hopefully folk will know what I mean when I say legit, because
if someone says legit, you get in there and try it, then you tell me it ain't legit.
Absolutely. I mean, I saw a photo go up on Twitter of someone put up a photo of the ring before the canvas goes over the top of it, and I'm just looking at it going, like, I've seen it in real life, like someone build a ring, and it's just, I couldn't imagine, I couldn't even contemplate doing it and landing on it.
It's not comfy. It's tough in that ring. But that's the one that annoys me. Oh, it ain't legit. You get in there, then I'll mess you up and show you how legit it is.
I'm happy to, again, I say this most podcasts, I'm happy to be on this side of the barrier. I'll stick with that. it's for everyone's safety, because not that I would smash anyone up, but you know, I would I'd make mistakes. That's probably the best way to put it. So of course, coming up, of course, we've got Peterhead. I don't know if you've been to Peterhead. I'm sure you've been to Peterhead before. Is there any pre-game?
Boxing shows, that sort of thing, yeah.
So pre-show bonbon, is it? Get your magic candy all sorted and then into the show.
Yeah, well, I don't eat candy. I'm an athlete.
A little bit of a sweet celebration after the match, you know?
After the celebration. Got to treat yourself now and then. I'm actually treating myself tonight. That's why I'm treating myself to an order tonight. So the weekend, man's got to eat good.
That's it. I mean, we're as exciting as it gets. I'm going to with Dice Farm for food tomorrow. I'm like buzzing because I look it's a carvery. I mean, there may be a chance if any photos come out of Regal Rumble that I might be asleep. It's because I ate well at the carvery. I ate well. So speaking of future, then this will come out, of course, April 7th. But looking into the future, we've got Peterhead, we've got Rugby Mania as well. But is there any places that does Meyhem Brooks have a promotion wish list that you want to try and hit to the next 12 months, or are you just taking every match as it comes?
I just want to get out there more. You know what I mean? I just want to show more people who I am, what I can do. I feel like I'm very overlooked in this wrestling game just now. Very overlooked. I don't know if that's just because I live far away from everyone. I'm out in the sticks. I don't know what it is, but I don't know. My goal is get more ring, like more matches, more promotions, meet more people, show everyone who I am.
I mean, that's it, because for yourself, you're quite a unique wrestler in Scotland. Like we were saying, there's not many people that have that kind of background that are as active. Of course, Chris Bunghard does quite a few things for like ICW brand, a wrestling experience in Scotland.
He's busy doing his thing as well, isn't he?
Yeah, so he's not 100% active in pro wrestling, whereas you are
committed.
Yeah, that's the best way to put it. So when it comes to like opponents, is there any, again, wish list that would be good for your style or good to expose yourself to a more a bigger audience? Is there anyone out there that you're like, I want to mix up with them?
Obviously, you and Raw, I need to mix it up for him, get him put in his place. Judas, like to get in there with him. Still craving that Ian Skinner match. He's another, he abandoned Elgin, so get him back here and let's show him why he shouldn't have abandoned this place.
That's it. That's the match I want. I want Meyhem Brooks, Ian Skinner, W3L, Bishop Mill Hall. I know, even Bishop Mill Hall, Town Hall.
Coming out of Edinburgh. Who are you? Coming out of Edinburgh. No, you ain't.
Traitor. I mean, I say he that. Is. I live here. I'm not from here. but yeah, that's it. Bishop Town Hall. I don't know why I want Bishop Mill. Bishop Mill's small in comparison. Town Hall, Marquee, Ian Skinner, Meyhem Brooks. A title, make up titles.
Off the place.
That's it. That's it. I mean, there'll be a fire hazard, especially with all that wood that's in there. which sounds terrible out of context, but anyone who knows the venue, it makes sense. It tracks. It's okay.
Yeah, if you know the venue, you get it.
Exactly. For the small minority that are from Elgin, probably listen to this.
The tiny base of wrestling fans of Elgin. That's a lie. We got a bit. When we show up, we get a good turnout.
Absolutely. It's great. That's why I want more wrestling here. Just like I said, not laziness. I want more wrestling here because
I'm here to represent this town. That's what I'm here to do.
All the belts as well. Get all the belts as well. As a guest that came on before I spoke to Krieger and Luke King Sharp, you have never answered our question about two sheep and one cow. So I think it's time. As a fighter, as someone who's been able to study fighting for a living, two sheep and one cow, who would win?
Tough one, isn't it? Probably the cow.
Have you
felt how hard a cow's noggin is?
Right, have you seen the video of a sheep knocking out a cow?
No.
Right, okay.
Sheep ain't knocking out a cow.
Right, I think I'd sent this to KOE and they said it was a lucky shot, but I still think it counts. So I will send it to you later on because it'll just...
You link that to me after.
So pretty much it's a cow versus a sheep. Cow tries it, sheep wins. That's all you need to know, but I will send you the link to it and you can...
Can you even set that up?
I don't know. It was just some farm. I love it. It proves my point exactly because if one sheep can do that, two sheep can do that, no bother. But anyway, right. And I can't remember if we asked you what your favorite dinosaur was last time.
You did, but I can't remember what I answered.
I mean, I'll just throw out there that this week I find out about the fuck you and Isaurus. Apparently, that is. Oh, I think it's called a foo q. Isaurus.
I seen that as well. I know which one
you're on
about, yeah.
It was Fiona who put that up, and as soon as I saw that, I was like, yes, I need to get that dropped somewhere because that's hilarious. Of course, opportunities in Scotland now. We've got, of course, Copenhagen Championship Wrestling, Danish promotion. Mm-hmm. Is that a place that you'd want to try and make your mark in and actually get wrestling in Europe as well?
Oh, 100%. I travel enough as it is anyway, so of course I want to get out there and show everybody. Not just Scotland, I want everyone to know who Meyhem Brooks is.
I mean, I don't want to cause controversy here, but I just realised I've just pulled up the video so I can link it to you later. And it's actually a goat that knocks out the cow. Oh, that's...
See, if you clarified that, then I might have changed my answer.
I mean, that changes the game. When I found this video, it was a sheep knocks out cow, but I've looked it up now and someone else has, they've either renamed it or if they've re-uploaded it. So there's controversy going on. I don't know if it's a cow or if it's a sheep or a goat now. It's all up in the air. It's a
mystery we need to solve.
That's it. And we have to contact these guys. And although the one that's 2.6 million views says goat. So I may have to believe that one out of the two.
When you go down dice, well, you could just set up your own one, just get a sheep or two sheep and a cow and just set up down and dice for us.
That's it. I mean, go to Dicey's. I could probably find a sheep and a cow. don't think it'll be the exact same kind of fight, but I'm sure we could find an Aberdeen fan. So again, looking forward, we mentioned that you just want to get wrestling again. Is there an end game? Is there a goal that you want to go, right, I want to get to NXT Europe, and then I'll get to WWE, or I want to get to AEW, or... Is there an end game that you can go, or Japan, that you go, right, I've fulfilled this, everything else is a bonus?
For me, end goal, realistically, have a belt on the telly. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. That's what I grew up watching. Someone had a belt on the telly, they're the real deal. For me, that'll solidify me as the real deal.
That's also a not only a doable goal, but that's a pretty cool goal to have as well. Like just wrestling on the telly, or just being interviewed with the belt and over your shoulder, just on the telly with a belt.
Belt on the shoulder. I'm still sweating after earning it. I've got it. Telling everyone, this is mine. Come get it. You know what I mean?
I mean, as far as belts go, is there any favorites that you have? Not just in Scottish wrestling, but just in general, is there any favorite belts that you like? Because of course I like the European, love the European belt, which is why I've got one. But is there any particular belt that you're like, that's the belt I imagine myself holding when I have this dream?
Like I said, the European belt was cool. My favorite one was the World Heavyweight Championship that they had in the WWE. Batista had it, Taker had it, the big gold one, Booker T's belt.
So that's actually, again, as either as King Booker or was it WCW? Is that the guy you think of with that belt?
It was originally the WCW belt, wasn't it? Mm-hmm. The World Heavyweight Championship. That was a nice belt.
It was, yeah. I mean,
big gold, just... You looked money when you had that on you.
See, the 2000s, man. The 2000s had such sweet belts because you had the big gold WCW, then you had... I mean, WCW, they put all their money in the big gold because the rest of their belts looked a bit crap. But you had the big the globe, big eagle for WWE. Yeah. You had the oval intercontinental title. The tag titles were sweet as well. It was, oh man, it was a great time to get. I mean, nowadays it'd be cool to. I mean, it'd be cool to win the WWE title, but when you see the title, it's just, it doesn't have that kind of same, like, amazing kind of belt.
They were big, golden, flashy back then.
Mm-hmm. I mean, wouldn't say
the
no.
AEW title's nice. That's a big, golden, nice belt. That's an example of what belt should look like, I think.
Mm-hmm. I mean, you wouldn't say no to it, but it would be a case of...
Of course not. Of course not.
It's not what I remember as a child kind of thing. We spoke about, like you say, you've got a couple matches you want to get in about, throwing Judas Grey about, throwing Raw about. Who's your dream? Again, we're talking about pinnacles here. Who are you beating for that belt?
The big match I've always wanted.
Yeah.
Are we talking old time, current time, anybody?
Let's choose alive, so it kind of makes the dream kind of a bit more realistic.
Give me Kurt Angle. Please. I know he's old enough, but just...
I bet he could still give you a run.
He would probably still give me a big run. Dan Severn as well. That, they are big, tough men, them two.
I mean, in the case of, like, say, Kurt, what about Chad Gable? Can that guy, I mean, if we have to kind of go...
Exactly, yeah. Chad Gable.
Is that your kind of bread and butter when it comes to watching wrestling? Is that what you enjoy, like wrestling wrestlers? Like Riddle, I suppose, out there as well, Matt Riddle. Is that the hype?
Yeah, Samoa Joe as well. He's legit jiu-jitsu-based guy. Just, I don't know. I like mat-based sort of wrestlers.
You like seeing the intricacies and the art of the wrestling, I suppose. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Someone like Kyle O'Reilly as well. He brings his background into it. Just as soon as he's got a limb... It's you see when he gets hold of a limb, they're holding that for the whole match. They're feeling it. You know what I mean?
Absolutely. I mean, I suppose nowadays I haven't seen a lot of his stuff, but Karrion Kross seems to kind of have that. He's a bit of a bigger guy, but he has that kind of background of being able to grab a body part and just torture it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think he's I don't know if he's a purple or brown belt in jiu-jitsu, so I know he's got it as well. Yeah.
Yeah, it's weird. It's like wrestling nowadays. There's kind of not two camps, but there's. It seems to be like guys that are, I don't know how to put this. I'll say their camp. Their camp is like legit backgrounds of jiu-jitsu, of a martial art. And you've got guys that are just passionate about pro wrestling as well. And it seems to be that's two camps nowadays in wrestling, which creates variety, I suppose. But it's bodybuilders as well. You've got bodybuilders and athletes. And there's no set way of wrestling now, which makes it more exciting.
I think everyone's just sort of, they know what they're comfortable with, they know what they're good at, let's throw this into the game. That's how I feel. I know what I'm good at, I know what I can do.
Of course, you did the aerial moment, I don't know if that's a one and done now, but is there anything that you'd want to try and push yourself? Would you want to try and do, I don't know, hurricanranas and all that kind of stuff, or are you just quite happy knowing what you can do and not wanting to take too much of a risk if you know you can do it well?
I wouldn't say I wouldn't add it in, but the time's got to be right, if that makes sense. The time was right for that aerial shot you got of me. I was there, Greg was there, I was up on that rope, so I'm up here, I can lamp this clothesline on him, and then the shot you got just made it look great.
Excellent. I'm just seeing the time now. We're kind of got to wrap up, but I've had an absolute blast. I think this is kind of a nice redemption for myself as well, to get to for us to both have a kind of comfortable chat where we're not both terrified. Well, yeah. I was terrified. You're of course cool as a cucumber, but I was terrified at the time. But no, it's been great being able to catch up with you for the show. Is there anything else you want to plug, or just your own social media before we wrap up?
Just my social media, Meyhem Brooks on Instagram, Twitter. Nothing really else to plug. You might see me wearing a black and gold Grapzilla hat or t-shirt now and then, but nothing set in stone yet.
So by the time this episode comes out, actually, you will be fighting in Peterhead that night. It's April 7th. I did write that down. So that's fine. So people can watch this episode, go up to Peterhead, and watch you batter a couple of fools. That seems like a good trade-off for folks. But no, again,
when you're watching this, I will be kicking ass, exactly.
That's great. But no, again, thank you again.